Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Yeah, I've got a really nice Keystone Cougar trailer to show you right now, a nice fifth wheel unit. It's called the 281, kind of a unique floor plan, relatively new to Keystone's lineup. If you're looking for something that's maybe a little bit smaller, this is part of their half ton series. So it's not a real heavy trailer, but it's laid out really well, so it's got a good livable floor space, but still keeping it on a smaller size trailer. One of the things we really like about Keystone, well, a lot of things. For one, these are Western Edition models, so they're built here in our area. They're built in Pendleton, Oregon, and I mentioned before they're part of the half ton series, so that's mostly what they build here in the Western Edition models are half ton towable units. So we like that. We like the fact they're a local company. Keystone has some of our best-selling product lines are all Keystone. They've been one of the top-selling fifth wheels on the market between the Cougar and the Montana. One or the other has been the best-selling fifth wheel in North America for probably 15 years in a row. So always a good reason for that. I like the way they're designed in the front cap. So if you do have a shorter truck, bed. This is designed to, it's cut away on the edges so you can see it's contoured. So if you do make a sharp cut, you're not likely to hit the back of your truck because of the way this is designed. Plus they bring the hitch out a little bit further too. You can see your hitch pin extends out a little bit further. So again, that puts the front of the trailer a little bit further behind the back of your cab of your truck as you're pulling this. It makes it better for maneuverability. We've also designed this with what they call a hitch vision with a light up in here, so actually if you're backing up you could look in your rear view mirror and see how you're lining up off of this here, so it makes it a little easier hooking up to your fifth wheel when you're backing up. Let's take a look over here on this side and we'll go in here for just a minute. Now so you can see you've got a couple of slide outs on this side of the trailer. This is typically your work side or your utility side of a trailer. So it's got your hookups and everything over here. 6 gallon hot water heater is a fast recovery. It heats up to 16 gallons an hour. It's gas or electric, so it operates very efficiently. I like the fact everything's enclosed in here now, so your hookups for your fresh water, your outside shower, all that's right in here. Even has a black tank flush. You can hook up your hose and help keep your black tank cleaned out. You can run your hose right up in through there and lock this down. Even your tank controls are right in here too. Notice it's got a lot of good storage, all pass-through storage all the way across. This unit is also equipped with auto level system, so you're going to really like this feature. Your controls right here, so when you're hooking up, once you unhook from your truck, you can hit your auto level and this will level out your unit. Just works just like a unit on a motorhome. Completely enclosed underbelly on this unit also, so everything underneath there is enclosed. Has radiant heat, so when your furnace is on you're going to have radiant heat all down underneath there. They even put that foil wrap, you know, their insulation on your tanks to help keep those insulated also. Propane tanks, one on each side. They split them up so you have better weight distribution. One of the things that Keystone really strives for is towability, so the idea is you keep your weight balance a little bit better. It's going to pull down the road nicer. Nice big storage up here in the front too. Going to come with a couple of batteries and battery boxes. We put your batteries up front. They've also gone to a feature that's really nice too. If you dry camp a lot, it's got a solar, it's wired for solar. So you could, if you had a little portable solar panel, you could plug in right here and keep your batteries charged up. Patio awning is electric. I like the idea that it's got the nice little magnet so you can just flip that up and it's going to lock into place. Other side of your pass-through storage, has lights, hookups right in here too, you can plug in. This is welded aluminum framing too, and I think when you open this up you can kind of see how this is designed. So your floor is all welded aluminum, sidewalls are the same. They do use some wood in your roof, some wood trusses, because it's a full walk-on roof. But if you look, I'm always impressed by the quality of the build on a Keystone. So your welds are not spot welded, it's full welded. I've seen some trailers where they'll hit it a couple of spots and call it good. But these, every weld is the same. It's a full weld all the way through. Better construction means it's going to hold up better for you on down the road. That's one of the reasons why the Cougar has one of the better reputations for resale too, because people know they are quality built trailers. Has a nice frameless window. All your windows are frameless now, except for the ones on the slide out on the side, they have frame. But outside speakers, slide outs on both sides. This actually has three slide outs, so for a smaller trailer you even have a 110 outlet there. Worth mentioning too, these have slide out bumpers. So this, there's a couple of pins, you just pull the pins, it slides out. You can have a little bit more storage. In fact, right behind you, you can see there's a trailer that has that pulled out. You can kind of see what it looks like when it pulls out. Great place to throw bikes, or maybe a generator. If you dry camp, you like to take your portable generator with you, you can put it right back there. Has a ladder to get up on top. Here's your back jacks. I mentioned that has the auto level. That's where your rear jacks are going to connect. Before we go in, I mentioned that they are insulated well, that they're fully enclosed underbelly. This actually is a 0 degree rated coat. So it has a polar package, and they do test these, and they put them in conditions at 0 degree temperatures for a certain period of time, make sure they don't fail, and they have passed at that temperature for however long they put them in that, probably at least 24 hours. But anyway, the idea is that you can take them out and use them in cold weather and not have everything fail on you. You're gonna like the floor plan on this. I really think this is a nice layout, because you do have opposing slides here. This opens up really well. It gives you additional counter space, room to work in the kitchen. Nice stainless steel sinks. Huge dinette in the back with lots of windows. A little bit longer table. This is going to fit quite a few, a lot more than just your typical standard dinette. And then in the kitchen area here too, you do have lots of drawers. Nice row of drawers here. Microwave. Three burner stovetop with 22 inch gas oven, a little bit bigger than what you see in some trailers. Even though they keep the weight down on these trailers, they don't decontent them, so they're still going to have lots of the features that are going to give you additional comfort and storage. Just like the refrigerator, they use an 8 cubic foot instead of the 6. They went to a little bit bigger refrigerator. Gives you a little bit more capacity. Like the fact it's got a little skylight there too, lets in some natural light. Comes with a flat screen TV. It's already set up, all your speakers are in, so you've got surround sound capability with DVD, CD, everything's right there ready to go. All you gotta do is slide it in there and you're ready to have some entertainment on those days where maybe the weather's not so nice, you're out camping, you wanna spend a little bit more time, at least wait for that storm to pass. Good storage. Does have a sleeper sofa. This is a trifold sleeper, so this will make into another bed. So the dinette will make into a bed. This will make into a bed. This folds out like a kind of like the conventional hide a bed, but it's designed a little differently. And they got away from the air bed, so you don't have to worry about pumping it full air. But I mentioned, you know, windows in the slide out. So you got nice big windows in the slide out. Lets in lots of light. Plus, they're open. You can open these windows too. Get some nice flow of air through here. Now this is a side aisle model. So as we go up into the bedroom area, you can see there's it's all on the side. So look at the amount of storage you have in here. Huge pantry. Well, you could just about use that for another room right there. Controls right here for all your slide outs. Easy to get to, centrally located. Lighting, tank controls right here where you check and see what your level tank levels. Turn on your hot water heater. I mentioned it's a fast recovery, so it operates off of direct spark, and it is electric or gas. Patio awning is electric too. So anyway, so the side aisle is going to give you a private bath. So your shower, sink, toilet, all in one unit here. Whether you have kind of a Jack and Jill situation, you have two ways to get into the bathroom. But that shower is a nice size shower, nice stand up shower. Porcelain toilet, toilet bowls. Gonna be a little easier to keep tidy with porcelain rather than just the plastic toilets. Now it does have a slide out here in the bedroom. Gives you additional wardrobe space. Plus the bed being up front, the way it runs, you do have storage underneath. It does come with a sink cover too, so that port of that sink that you have, a stainless steel sink in your kitchen, has a cover, so it gives you a little bit of additional room to work with. Looks like it's got a nice queen size bed with a nice nightstand next to it with drawers, and then you got another space right here where you can hang clothes, and storage up above. Really utilizes storage quite well in this. Nice layout, not too big, but you can see it's got a good amount of storage. Again, it's a 281 model, so the length is really kind of moderate, I guess, when you consider the size of fifth wheels is on the smaller side rather than the bigger side. But I like the fact it's got, with the three slide outs, it gives you good livable space in here. So love to tell you a little bit more about it. If you would get a hold of me, I'd sure appreciate it. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. So please ask for me. Again, it's Jim Beckler here at the RV Corral, and I'd love to help. Thank you.